Most of the plots generated by monoliths, either to visualize the data or to diagnose the model, can be stratified according to the covariates in the dataset. For example, in this project, I can use any of these 5 covariates for stratification: the weight and sex of each individual, its genotype, the dose it has received, and the study to which it belongs. In addition to the covariates, the column occasion can also be used to stratify. This is very useful for us to explore the dataset, for instance in the data viewer. I can see at once on this plot of the observations with respect to time that there are different treatment designs in the dataset. I will first choose a log scale for the y-axis to see a bit better the data and add some information on the dataset statistics. Now in the panel Stratify, I can use the covariate design to stratify the curves corresponding to different treatment designs. By clicking on Allocate, I create 2 groups corresponding to the 2 values, MD for multiple doses and SD for single dose. There are now 3 options to stratify the data: split, color, and filter. Let's begin with split, which creates a new group for each plot. Notice that the statistics in the information are updated as well for each plot. So there are 36 subjects for MD and more than 130 for SD. Let's replace the information by the legend and add a stratification group for dose. I am now going to color each dose group. The categories can also be reorganized in different groups. For example, if I want only 4 groups, I can put together the values of those that are close. I can also personalize the colors. Another stratification option is individual selection, that allows to display one individual at a time that can be chosen with this slider. Notice that any coloring option selected before remains during the individual selection. In this dataset, there can be several occasions per individual with different doses. Several individuals can also be displayed at the same time. Now let's split by dose and color by genotype. We can immediately see an effect of the genotype on the pharmacokinetics. Next, I can also check a potential effect of weight. I will first use the option Filter to select the individuals with genotype 0 in order to focus on the possible effect of weight only. The rest of the data will be filtered out. For continuous covariates, groups can be created by clicking on plus and choosing a delimiting value. I can also choose groups with equal quant or equal width. I see that the groups of individuals according to weight seem to cluster together with respect to the Cmax, so a covariate effect of weight might be relevant as well. In contrast, coloring by sex does not reveal any clear effect. In conclusion, the stratification of the observed data allowed to understand the organization of the dataset and has revealed a clear effect of genotypes on the curves and a possible effect of weight. Similarly to the data viewer, in monoliths all the diagnostic plots can also be stratified. For example, I can split the scatter plot of the residuals by treatment design and color it by dose. I can also split the distribution of the individual parameters by the genotype. I find that the distribution of CL is widely different for the 2 genotype groups. This suggests to add a covariate effect of the genotype on CL. Plots like the VPC can also be split, for example, with the treatment design. Finally, when saving the project, all the stratification choices are saved in a properties file, so that the same stratification will still appear when I reload the project. This concludes this video on stratifying. Enjoy this feature in your own monolith project and see you soon for another video.